document understanding, you're used to probably that more structured type of documents can be read by AI, by machine learning. But now there's all different kinds of new developments, which we're going to discuss with Kristian DeVito. You're the senior AI machine learning solution engineer at UiPath.
Yes.
And we're here at UiPath Forward 7 in Las Vegas.
So
nicely outside, beautiful weather.
Mm-hmm.
But that's not what we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about document understanding. So can you give examples where document understanding is used? Documents are used everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Where's document understanding used?
Yeah, so I think one of the really interesting things about document understanding and the solution in itself is that pretty much every large corporation, every industry has massive amounts of paperwork, kind of a paperwork document problem. And it's not the most enjoyable experience for the folks having to go in and process all those documents. So if we're able to automate some of that, which we are, that can touch all the different industries. So if you think from oil and gas, if you think invoices coming in, healthcare, right? All of the patient information that they have to process, large use cases in finance, and then public sector, if you think tax forms. So the use cases are pretty exponential. They touch every industry. So just a few examples.
And what's the problem? You said the document problem. So on one hand, you have a lot of unstructured documents.
Mm-hmm.
What's exactly the problem, and how is this going to change?
Yeah, so initial problem was that it can be easy to process very structured documents and pieces of information. And that's kind of what we think of when we think of traditional document processing. But with some of the new capabilities that we're adding in around generative, we can now process unstructured documents. So now you're taking sometimes large pieces that people were having to do manually that maybe didn't make it make sense for them to use an automated solution if they're only able to automate, you know, 50% of their documents. Now we're able to address all of the different use cases within an organization. So think something highly structured, maybe something semi-structured, and then also fully unstructured information, and also things like communications coming in or emails. We can extract data and key pieces of information from that as well.
But can you give an example on how it was before, where maybe 50 or 80% needs to be manually processed and what that meant, and now it can be fully automated?
Yeah, so like example from just one specific industry or one specific use mm-hmm. case. Yeah, so I guess let's think kind of like a health insurance claim coming in. They file that initial claim, but there's usually a lot of supporting documents, maybe letters from the doctor that are important and relevant to process as well. Communications or information coming in from the patients. That would be some of the unstructured documents mm-hmm. that are now able to be processed with generative. But then things like the actual invoice or the structured information are things that we're able to do with our out-of-the-box machine learning models or customized machine learning models. So really the whole entire gambit can be addressed now.
And with the LLMs, it can be retrieved. And once you have the data, actions can be taken. And that's what was Danielle, your CEO, was explaining with the Agentic AI mm-hmm. new approach, where you initially could do two steps with RPA from the five or six steps. And now with Agentic, you can basically do all steps and take the actions with the help of the agents and with the help of the robots.
Yeah, exactly. So not just getting that information out, you can complete an entire end-to-end process. So from the initial data ingestion to getting the things that you need, and then to ultimately decision-making and actions that are taken from that. So whether that's updating that information in some external system or making a full decision to send a communication or email back to that patient, or really the possibilities are pretty endless. With not just RPA, but now the addition of agents and agentic AI.
So good news for everybody who has to process documents and spends a lot of time on it. There's all different new agentic AI related functionality coming where you can be helped and do it much faster and easier.
Mm-hmm.
Kristian, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching here from Las Vegas, from UiPath Forward, and look forward to seeing you next time.